Jesus Christ. Let us bow our heads for prayer. The Lord bless every one of us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We will not hear this in vain in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Father, eternal Rock of Jesus, we bless your holy name this morning. We thank you because you are God. We thank you because we never shall be with anyone. Holy Spirit divine, speak to me today again in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let your power manifest the love of your people in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Give your people the grace to overcome the adversary, the grace to turn the adversary and their battles to dust in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Praise God. Somebody shout a powerful hallelujah. You are welcome once again. The Lord will bless you as you listen this morning. The topic of my sermon this morning is turning your adversary and your battles to dust. Turning your adversaries and your battles to dust. Praise the living Jesus Christ. The adversary is the greatest level of the enemy. The adversary is the unrepentant enemy. The adversary is the unforgiving enemy. The adversary in this context is Satan. We are talking here about spiritual adversary. We are talking here about spiritual battles. The Lord will bless you as you listen in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The adversary have been ordained, anointed, empowered to put your life into the dust. You must arise against your spiritual adversary. Because whatsoever that happens in the realm of the spirit must manifest in the physical. Unless you stand against it in prayer and by the word of God. Satan is the adversary of this generation. And he has gotten his agents in human vessels. The moment has come to know how to deal with this adversary. Praise the living Jesus Christ. The Bible says in the book of Revelation chapter 12, verse 11, and they overcame him, the dragon, the old serpent Satan, by the blood of the Lamb, and by those of their testimony, and they did not fear their life unto the death. Praise the living Jesus Christ. Before I go deeply into the scripture this morning, I want you to open your Bible to Luke chapter 10. I want us to read verse 18 and 19. Christ says something. He said, I beheld Satan fell as lightning. Praise the Lord. In verse 19, I've given you power to tear upon the serpent and scorpion, and over all the power of the enemy, and they shall not be able to hurt you. Praise the living Jesus Christ. The anointing, the grace, the empowerment to overcome your spiritual adversary and your battle is settled through Christ Jesus. Brethren, listen to me. The anointing is readily available. The anointing is already there. We are seated in Christ Jesus at the right hand of the Father, far above. Principalities, powers, and might. We are seated in Christ Jesus at the right hand of the Father, far above. Principalities, powers, and might. The grace is already there. Grace is the mother of anointing. The anointing is already there. The strength is already there. The power is already there. the enablement is already there. 1 John 4:4, for whatsoever that is born of God overcomes the world, and this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. Praise the living Jesus Christ. Before you can turn your adversaries and your battle to dust, you must experience the new salvation in Christ Jesus. You must be genuinely born again. I'm not talking about your title. Before you become a prophet, apostle, pastor, the first thing you become is to become a child of God. You must experience the new salvation according to Acts chapter 3, verse 19. That says, repent ye therefore, and be ye converted, so that your sins may be blotted out, and a time of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. You need to experience genuine repentance, no matter your sin. You need to experience true compassion. If you experience genuine repentance and true compassion, then it is the greatest weapon to turn your adversaries and your battles to dust. Listen to me. We have seen every promises in the scripture. Like Psalm 27 verse 1 and 2. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the Lord of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat of my flesh, they all stumbled and fell. Oh. We have a lot of promises in the scripture. I wonder, why we think, as just any human being that has lost another is left to Christ, that those scripture promises are for us. They are for genuinely born again Christians. Psalm 91. He that dwelleth in the scriptures of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the use of pestilence. He shall cover me with His feathers. All these scriptural promises, they are for people that are genuinely born again. Because the power of being the Son of God, the Son of the living God, is the power and anointing. The major power and anointing that can make you to turn your adversaries and your battles to dust. No matter how great your enemy is, no matter how strong your enemy is, no matter how powerful your enemy is, God, the anointing in the Holy Ghost, the anointing in Christ is greater than them. This is very, very important. Point number two, before you can turn your spiritual adversaries and your battles to dust, there's one thing you need to check in your life as a child of God. You need to overcome the spirit of fear. Proverbs 28 verse 1 says about fear. Said the righteous shall be bold as a lion. Said, but the wicked shall fall utterly. Praise God. The righteous shall be bold as a lion, but the wicked shall fall utterly. Wow. You must achieve boldness. You must conquer the spirit of fear. One of the major ingredients of faith is boldness, confidence, courage. You need this to overcome your adversary, to turn your adversary to dust, to turn your battles to dust. You need this. You need to acquire the spirit of boldness. If you are fearful, if you are frightful, you must pray for that power of goodness. You must receive it. And you can only receive it by the word of the scripture. You can only receive it by prayer and fasting and by living a pure and holiness life. Point number three, Obadiah chapter 1, verse 17. That is the major key that says, upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance and holiness, and the house of Jacob they shall possess their possession. You must continue in obedience to God, doing the will of God. This is the major point that can make you to turn your adversity to dust. The Lord bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Listen to this. I've told you in my former sermon about the ministry, the three missiles of the enemy, of the adversary, Satan. According to John chapter 10, verse 10, to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Those are the three ministries. But there are agents of this ministry that you need to overcome. You need to stand against them. There are seven agents of the ministry of the adversary that you must turn them to dust. We have seven of them. Number one, the agent of sin. The agent of sin is one of the agents of the ministries of the adversary that we must overcome. The agent of sin. What is the function of the agent of sin? The agent of sin will tell you that if you commit fornication, you just pray for seven, just do 7 day dry fasting, and God will forgive you. The agent of sin will encourage you to commit sin. The agent of sin will introduce you to the nightclub. The agent of sin will introduce you to a strange woman. The agent of sin will introduce you to a strange man. The agent of sin will introduce you to alcohol. The agent of sin will introduce you to drug. The agent of sin will introduce you to anything that is against the will of God. The agent of sin will tell you that after you have prayed, you have fasted, and you have not received solution on time, you can go. He will tell you to go to the herbalist. The agent of sin will tell you to go to Occult House to seek for solution. The agent of sin will tell you, oh yeah, you can go to a native doctor. The agent of sin will tell you that God has failed you. You can try another means. There is no other alternative to your solution. Every other solution has failed. The only solution that is reigning is the solution in the power of anointing of the Holy Ghost in Christ Jesus. Number two. Agent number two. Agent of negativity. Who is an agent of negativity in the ministry of your adversary? When you look at your dream life, it's written negative, it's written death, sickness, affliction. You look at your dream life, you look at your thinking, you look at your imagination, everything is negative. There is agent of negativity in your life that you need to conquer before you can turn your adversaries to dust and your battles to dust. When your heart is filled with negativity, negative thoughts, negative thinking, your dream life too will be filled with negativity. Contrary dreams, nightmares, dream of affliction, attacks, spiritual attacks, and you begin to see the attack manifesting in the physical. The agent of negativity will do that. The agent of negativity will tell you that you cannot do it. You are too small to do it. The agent of negativity will tell you that you don't have the emotional potential to do it. The agent of negativity will tell you that you are too small for it. The agent of negativity will tell you that, oh, forget it. You don't have enough experience to do it. But the agent of positivity will tell you that with God, all things are possible. Agent number three, the agent of mockery. The agent of mockery and the agent of negativity, they work together. The agent of mockery will say, can any good thing come from your Nazareth? God hates mockery. The agent of mockery will tell you that, you want to disgrace yourself. The agent of mockery will say, I will disgrace him. The agent of mockery will tell you, look here, you better don't go for that because it's for big men. The agent of mockery will tell you that he can do it better than you. The agent of mockery will tell you that your age is too small for that. That your age is higher or smaller than that, the agent of mockery will tell you that, hello, you better don't try it because you are going to fail. Remember the story of Nathanael in the scripture. When Christ was introduced to Nathanael, Nathanael said that, can any good thing come from Nazareth? After that encounter, how much have you heard about the ministry of Nathanael among the disciples of Jesus Christ, among his apostles? God hates mockery. God hates mockery. Anybody that mocks you is mocking the God that created you. Is mocking the one that is created in the image and the likeness of God. Maybe you might have failed before. The agent of mockery will begin to point where you have failed to you. He will tell you that you have failed before. But God says that, remember you not the former thing, behold, I will do a new thing. God is not interested in your failure. God is not interested in your past failure. God is not interested where you have failed, where you have backslided. God is not interested in whatsoever evil that have happened to you before. God says, I will do a new thing. So you are going to cling yourself unto God because he has promised to do a new thing in your life. That your failure will turn to success. That your sickness will turn to healing, supernatural healing. That your backwardness will turn to greater destiny. Oh, listen to me. The moment has come to recognize all these agents of your adversity that you need to overcome. Agents, number four, agent of impossibility. The agent of impossibility will tell you, look here, we speak to your heart, look here, it is not possible. Nobody has done it in your family. You cannot succeed without it. Just stop it. Don't go, don't even go further. The agent of impossibility. Oh, they will tell you that nobody has done marriage in your family before. They will tell you that nobody has tried a car in your family before. They will tell you that nobody has put out in your family before. The agent of impossibility will make you to remember every faulty foundation that you have got. The agent of impossibility. Agent number five. Agents of gossip. Blackmail, slander. There are very, very many in this generation. When they see the glory shining, when they see the grace of God upon your life, they want to pull you down. Yeah. They want to kill your destiny by the power that Satan that they possess inside their tongue. You can overcome them. Some people, they are looking for recognition by criticizing you negatively. Agent of gossip and blackmail. They will not give you constructive criticism. They will give you negative criticism. If you begin to listen to them, you begin to answer them, then you don't know what you are doing. That is the agent of gossip. Agent of backbiting. They can tell you the story of your foundation. They can tell you the journey that you have acquired before, where you have failed before. God says, don't look back like the wife of Lot. Continue in the strength of the Holy Ghost, and you will get there in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Point number six, agent number six, agent of mistake and error. This is very, very important. You need to take care of this agent of mistake and error. Agent of mistake and error will bring negative counsel to you. There will be counsel that is not in the will of God to you, that you should accept it, you should do it. Agent of mistake and error will give you human solution rather than godly solution. The last agent, the agent of distraction. The agent of distraction. They will introduce new ideas to you to make you to lose your focus in God, to make you to lose your focus in your glorious destiny. Agent of distraction. As in 2 Timothy chapter 2, the case of Elisha and Elijah. When Elisha was about to see the anointing of Elijah, his master, they were trying to distract him from verse 1. Other people of the prophet, they were telling him, don't you know that God will take your master away from you today? He refused to be distracted. He said, I know, keep quiet. He said, I know, keep quiet. He told them to keep quiet because they had tried to distract him. Nothing less than 5-6 times they were telling him, Elisha, don't you know? Don't you know? Don't you know? He said, keep quiet. He refused to be distracted. The agent of distraction will make you to lose your focus in God, in Christ Jesus. Like Peter on the sea. He was moving towards Christ on the sea. Christ says, Peter, come. And instead, he became distracted. And he started sinking. The agent of distraction will make your destiny to sink. They will make your glory to sink. And I prophesy over your life that your destiny will not sink. Your glory will not sink. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Listen to me. Let me add one more. The agent of your foundation. The agent of your foundation is the spiritual entity of your father's house. The powers of darkness. The foundational powers of your father's house, the foundational causes, evil covenant of your father's house, the foundational weakness of your father's house, they want to stop you from reaching your destiny. The foundational idols and stressor deity, and stressor God and goddesses, we want to stop you. They want to put a mark and a stop on you. I will not feel your destiny in the living God. Listen to me. I prophesy upon your life that every agent of your foundation that is ministering demotion, failure, backwardness upon your life, I command them to die in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Agent of sin in your life, I command them to be uprooted by fire. Agent of negativity in your life, in your heart, I command them to die by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. Agent of impossibility in your life, I command them to die in the name of Jesus Christ. Agent of gossip, blackmail, backbiting in your life. Agent of slander in your life, in your destiny, I command them to be uprooted by Holy Ghost fire. I decree negative people, contrary people that is surrounding your destiny, either all that are surrounded your destiny, I command them in the name of Jesus Christ to be uprooted by Holy Ghost fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And I command them to be replaced by men of plural destiny, destiny helpers that is greater than them. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, every door that will be opened up into your life to attract all these agents of your adversary, I command that door to be closed now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I decree and I declare that where your generation has failed, you will succeed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Listen to me very carefully. The time has come for you to live a life of complete surrender to Christ Jesus. The Lord will bless you. You might have failed before, you will succeed. You might have fallen before, you will arise again. Arise and shine in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for listening. You are blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Thank you. You are blessed.